First, we will set reference for capacitor voltage and capacitor current. This is IC and this is reference for VC. The reference current is from positive to negative. So, we will write it as IC equal to plus C dVC by dt. Now, this is the external, this may be the external circuit I was talking about. Before t equal to 0, the switch was closed and this was short. So, the whole current, whole I current will flow from this short circuited path. At t equal to 0, this switch was open circuited. Now, if this path is not available, this I current will flow from capacitor. So, after t equal to 0 or from the instant t equal to 0, I c will be equal to I. So, we will say that from t equal to 0, I c is equal to I, which is equal to C d V c by d t. And suppose it has initial voltage as 0, no initial voltage. So, we will write it as d V c is equal to I by C into d t. Now, integrate it. Since I is constant, at t equal to 0, there was no capacitor voltage, so 0, and at any time t, suppose the capacitor has voltage V c t. So, we will get expression V c t, the capacitor voltage at any instant t is equal to I by C into t, and we will get V c t versus t, a straight line passing through origin. To generalize this case, suppose instead of t equal to 0, the switch was closed at any instant t naught, and before closing the switch, the capacitor has a voltage of V naught. So, the switch was opened, not closed. The switch was opened at t equal to t naught. So, after the switch was opened, after that instant only the I c will be I. So, this equation is valid only after or from t equal to t naught, and at t equal to t naught the capacitor voltage was V naught. So, this will be, this is same as we did in case of inductor. This will be V c t minus V naught is equal to I by C into t minus t naught, or capacitor voltage is equal to the initial capacitor voltage plus I by C into t minus t naught. So, the general graph will be, this will be the general graph, and the slope is I by C. This is V c t and this is t. In this circuit also, we have to find out inductor current in terms of time, inductor current at any instant of time. But before solving for this equation, before solving for inductor current, we will first try to find out the inductor current at two instants. The first instant is, suppose the switch is closed at t equal to 0, we will find out the inductor current at t equal to 0 plus and at t equal to infinity, or in t equal to infinity means the steady state. And since I have introduced a new term, steady state, so first we will try to understand the meaning of steady state in case of DC circuit. In case of DC circuits, the meaning of steady state is the state or the time when the voltage across or the current through each element becomes constant. Suppose this is I L T. So, in a steady state the inductor current will be constant. Suppose V L is inductor voltage. So, in a steady state V L will be constant. The voltage and current, the voltage across each element and current through each element becomes constant in a steady state in case of DC circuit also. In AC circuit we will have slightly different definition of a steady state, because in AC circuit even if a steady state is reached, the instantaneous quantity keeps changing. So, but I am restricting this definition up to DC circuits only. So, in a steady state, IL becomes constant, VL becomes constant. Now, if we write down equation of voltage through inductor, this is L dIL over dt. Now, if the steady state is reached, the current is constant. So, now if the current is constant, dIL over dt will be 0. So, we will say that VL is always equal to 0, or we can say that in a steady state, if voltage across inductor is 0, we will say that inductor is short circuited. So, we will say that in a steady state, the inductor current is constant at any value, but VL is constant at 0. Similarly, in case of capacitance, IC will be constant and voltage across capacitor will be constant. In case of capacitor, we write this type of this equation, IC equal to dVC by dt. Now, if voltage is constant, IC will be 0. So, we will say that in a steady state, capacitor voltage is constant at any value, and IC is constant at, this is constant at 0. So, these are the four statements in case of, in the state of, in a steady state. And we already know that at t equal to 0 plus, or the next instant after the transient has occurred, suppose the switch is closed at t equal to 0, then we will say that the transient has occurred at t equal to 0. So, at the next instant, we know that inductor current IL will not change, or it will retain its previous value, will not change, and the capacitor voltage will not change. Or we say that dIL is equal to, the change in inductor current is equal to 0. If we write equation for delta IL, we write it as the rate of change of inductor current into delta t. Delta IL can be written as in the short duration, if delta t tends to 0, we can write delta IL is equal to rate of change of inductor current in the into multiplied by short interval. Now, at the instant of switching instant, we say that delta IL is equal to 0. The reason for delta IL is to be 0 is that delta t tends to 0, but this quantity is still be finite. If this quantity tends to 0, change in inductor current is 0 because this quantity tends to 0, not this quantity. So, right after the instant of, after the closing the switch, dIL over dt may still be not equal to 0. This may still be finite, because to make this 0, delta t is 0. So, this may still be finite. So, we will try to calculate dIL over dt at t equal to 0 plus. So, suppose at t equal to 0, switch was closed, and we need to find out the current through inductor at t equal to 0 plus. Now, suppose before switching the closed switch, the inductor current was 0, and the difference between the two instant is tending to 0. So, the inductor current will IL will be 0 at t equal to 0 plus. There will be no change in inductor current. Now, if IL is equal to 0, the whole voltage will drop if we apply KVL. If the switch is connected, we will apply KVL here. KVL can be applied at any instant, whether the circuit is in a steady state or the circuit is in transient. KVL is always applicable. So if this switch is closed, if we apply KVL, we will say that this is VR, V is equal to, or VS is equal to VR plus VL, or VS is equal to, VR is equal to I into R, the current into resistance plus VL. Now at t equal to 0 plus IL is equal to 0, since IL is equal to IR at t equal to 0 plus, VS is equal to VS and current is 0, so voltage dropped in the resistance will be 0 plus VL. So we will say that at t equal to 0 plus, the inductor voltage is equal to VS and inductor voltage is equal to L dIL over dt. So dIL over dt at t equal to 0 plus, this will be equal to VS by L. Suppose VS equal to 10 volt as we took in example, and inductor current is equal to 1 milli Henry. So dIL over dt at t equal to 0 plus will be equal to VS is equal to 10 volt divided by 1 milli Henry. This is 10,000 ampere per second. This is very high, but it's still finite. We will put 10,000 ampere per second in delta t tends to 0. So we will put it as 10 to power minus 20. So what will be the value of change in inductor current? This is still 0. So at t equal to, since we are analyzing at t equal to 0 plus, IL is equal to 0, but the rate of change of inductor current is 10,000 ampere per second if we take these values. We are analyzing it at t equal to 0 plus. T equal to 0 plus. If IL is equal to 0, then IR is also equal to 0. If IR is equal to 0, then VR is also equal to 0. And if VR is equal to 0, VL is equal to VS, which is 10 volt in this case. So these are the values at t equal to 0 plus. Now, if we analyze at t equal to infinity, which is a steady state, in steady state, I said that the voltage across inductor is equal to L dIL over dt and everything becomes constant. So, VL is equal to 0. Now, if we apply KVL, we will get it as VS equal to VR plus VL and VL is 0. So, VR is equal to VS and VR is equal to resistance current into resistance. So, IR will be VS by R. And since resistance and inductors are connected in series, so the value of IL is equal to IR. So, in a steady state, inductor current is equal to resistance current is equal to source voltage by R. As I also said that in a steady state, inductor becomes constant. So, the current will be VS by R. Voltage across inductor is 0. Then the voltage across resistance is equal to Vs. So these are steady state values. So we will denote it as, and mathematically a steady state occurs at t equal to infinity only. This will be understood little later. Mathematically, the steady state will occur at t equal to infinity only, and practically, this may occur at very short duration. So, the steady state is at t equal to infinity only. So, we will denote it as IL infinity, VL infinity, VR infinity, and these are at initial stage. So, we will represent at IL naught, DIL naught, IR naught, VR naught or VL naught. Initial quantity will be represented as IL naught and the steady state quantity will be represented as IL infinity. Okay. So, after doing this much, now let us try to find out the inductor current at any time t. Here we found out the inductor current only at two instants, right after the switching instant and in steady state. Now we have to find out at any time t, which is between in switching instant and steady state. The switch is closed at t equal to 0. So after t equal to 0, we can connect it. From the instant t equal to 0, this is connected. So we'll apply, if we apply KVL here, we will say that Vs, here we will get a drop minus Vr, here also we will get a drop minus VL equal to 0. So Vs is equal to Vr plus VL, or Vs is equal to Vr is equal to I into R, Ir into R plus L dIL over dt. Since these two elements are connected in series, so Ir, IL will be same. So we will denote it as simply I. Vs is equal to Ir plus L dI over dt. Or we will say that L dI over dt is equal to Vs minus I into R, or dI over Vs minus IR is equal to 1 by L dt. Now use integration both sides. The switch was closed at t equal to 0. So from t equal to 0 only this equation is valid, and at t equal to 0, suppose the inductor, first I am assuming that the initial inductor current was 0. So at t equal to 0, the inductor current is 0. At any time t, the inductor current is, suppose this is I t. So if we integrate it, we will get it as minus 1 by R ln V s minus I R limit from 0 to I t is equal to 1 by L into t. So from here we will get, if you solve it, we will get I t as 1 by R into 1 minus e to power minus t divided by, or R t divided by L, e to power minus R t divided by L. Or this is very easy to solve, you just need to put the limits Vs by R into 1 minus e to power minus t divided by tau, where tau is equal to, if you take R tau, this will be L by R. So t divided by tau, so tau is equal to L by R. This is called time constant. Now we will try to generalize it, generalizing in the sense that suppose the inductor was carrying an initial current, instead of initial zero current, let us assume that the inductor was carrying an initial current I naught. Suppose the value is I naught, the initial inductor current is I naught. So instead of 0, we will use I naught, and the switch is closed at any time t naught. This t naught may be 1 second, 2 second. So this will be t naught here. Now what will be the changes? Instead of 0 here, we will use I naught. This is I naught, and instead of t, we will use here t minus t naught. T minus t naught. Now if we put the limit, 1 by R is constant, so I am taking it out, minus ln V s minus I R from limit I naught to I t is equal to 1 by L. Now, this is the time duration. We can say that this is the time duration from the instant of switching. Suppose the switching is done at t not equal to 1 second and you are asked to find out the current at t equal to 5 second. So, you will integrate it from 1 second to 5 second. So, you will get here 4 second. So, what is the 4 second? 4 second is the duration from the switching instant, these two duration. So, the instant instead of using t, we have to use here del t. But if the switching is done at t not equal to 0, if this is 0, so the duration becomes equal to the absolute time. So, we will have to take care if the switching instant is some time which is not equal to 0. Now, put the limits 1 by r, this will be ln V s minus I naught r divided by V s minus I t into r. This is equal to 1 by delta t by L, or if we take r this side, this will become r delta t by L. If we take ln this side, we will get e to power r delta t by L, or V s minus I naught r, or if we interchange it, V s minus I t into r divided by V s minus I naught r is equal to, here we will have minus sign if we interchange it. This will be minus r delta t divided by L. So, V s minus I t into r is equal to V s minus I naught into r. I naught is initial current and I t is inductor current at any instant of time t. This is equal to this into e to power minus t divided by tau, delta t divided by tau, where delta t is the duration after the switching instant and tau is equal to time constant, which is equal to L by r, or in general form this is L by r equivalent. I will tell you meaning of this. So, here we will get I t is equal to 1 by r into V s minus I naught r into e to power minus t divided by tau, or current inductor current at any time is equal to V s by r minus, this is V s by r minus I naught. If you take r n, this will be V s by r, and here r and r will be cancelled. So, we will get I naught into e to power minus t divided by tau. Now, what is this value V s by r? If we analyze this circuit in a steady state, the voltage across inductor is 0. So, irrespective of the initial value of inductor current, the steady state inductor current I infinity is always equal to V s by r, because in a steady state the voltage of across inductor will be 0. It does not matter what is the initial inductor current, and if the inductor voltage is 0, the voltage across resistance will be V s. So, the steady state inductor current or steady state resistance current is equal to V s by r. So, here instead of V s by r, I am using it I infinity, because it is independent of initial condition, minus I infinity minus I naught into e to power minus t divided by tau. So, if you want to find out, or if you have the steady state inductor current and a steady state initial current, then at any instant of time you can find out the inductor current. And finding out steady state value of inductor current or initial inductor current is very easy, because in a steady state inductor voltage is inductor voltage is 0. So, in this example you can see that finding out inductor in steady state inductor current is very easy. So, finding out these two quantity is very easy. So, instead of deriving all this equation, if we are asked to find out inductor current, we will use this formula. And the quality of this formula is, this formula is not valid only for inductor current. This is valid for inductor current, inductor voltage, resistance current, resistance voltage, and not only in this circuit, in any first order circuit, whether this is RL circuit or RC circuit, in all case this formula is valid. We will say that, suppose instead of writing voltage or current, I am just writing a general quantity xt. Xt is equal to x at any time t is equal to the value of x in a steady state minus value of x infinity minus x naught into e to the power minus t divided by tau. And in case of RL circuit, tau is equal to L by R, and in case of RC circuit, tau is equal to simply R into C. So, we have the general formula, and I am not going to derive it for RC circuit, because the derivation is the procedure is same. Or let me just write down the equation of in case of RC circuit, let me write down the equation up to this part only. Or before moving to RC circuit, let us do an example on this formula. Suppose this switch is closed at t equal to 0. The value of resistance is, suppose this is 100 ohm, and the inductance is 10 milli Henry, and we are asked to find out inductor current at t equal to 0.1 millisecond. Suppose we have to find out inductor current at t equal to 0.1 millisecond. So, to find out current at any instant, we just need to find out the value of current in a steady state, the value of initial inductor current. So, suppose in this question we are given that the initial inductor current is 0. So, we will use I naught equal to 0. The initial inductor current is not before closing the switch. We will always use the initial inductor current just after closing the switch. So, before closing the switch the inductor current was 0. So, after closing the switch the instant is very, the duration is very small. So, even after the closing the switch the initial inductor current will be 0. In case of inductor current this is same, but in case of if we use for inductor voltage, the inductor voltage can change suddenly. So, in that case the initial inductor voltage at t equal to 0 minus and the inductor voltage at t equal to 0 plus, these two quantity will not be same. We will see it in an example, maybe in this example only. So, now suppose you are asked to find out inductor voltage at any time t. You will use it as inductor voltage in infinite time minus V L infinity minus V naught into e to power minus t by tau. So, what I want to convey here is which value of initial inductor voltage you will take, this value or this value. you have to take initial inductor voltage, this value, after the closing the switch. And in case of inductor voltage, these two values are not same. Although in case of inductor current, IL naught at t equal to 0 minus 2 plus, but inductor voltage or capacitor current may not be same. So you have to take initial inductor voltage just after closing the switch. We will see it in this example only, how it is not equal. In this case, suppose initial inductor current is equal to 0. Now, what is the value of final inductor current? Suppose this voltage is 200 volt. So, in steady state, inductor is short circuited. So, the current will be 2 ampere. So, we will use it as ILT equal to I infinity minus I naught into e to power minus t divided by tau. I infinity equal to 2 ampere. And what is tau? Tau is equal to L by R. So, tau is equal to L equal to 10 milli Henry divided by resistance equal to 100 ohm. So, this is 0.1 millisecond. Instead of delta t, instead of t, we must use delta t. Since the switch is closed at t equal to 0. So, delta t, whether we write t or delta t, it does not matter. So, we will use I infinity equal to 2 minus I naught equal to 0 e to power minus, time duration is given as 0.1 millisecond, this is 0.1, and tau is equal to 0.1 millisecond. So, this is 2 minus 2 into e to power minus 1. So, this will be around approximately 37% of 2. This will be around 37%. This will be around 63% of 2. This will be approximately 1.26 ampere. IL at t is equal to 0.1 millisecond. Here we have used numerical values. Let us try to find out the formula in terms of variables only. So, I infinity in this case will be V s by R minus V s by R, I naught is equal to 0. So, minus 0 into e to power minus t divided by tau, or I L t is equal to V s by R into 1 minus e to power minus t divided by tau. Now, if inductor current is known, we can also find out the voltage across this resistance. Let us use variables only. So, if inductor current is this, resistance current will be same. So, the resistance voltage V R is equal to this current into resistance. So, if you multiply it by R, we will get V S into 1 minus e to power minus t divided by tau. Now, the KVL is always applicable. So, V S is equal to V R plus V L, or V L is equal to, this is the reference for V L, this is the reference for V R, V L is equal to V S minus V R. So, V L at any time t is equal to V S minus, the value of V R at any time t is equal to this, V S into 1 minus e to power minus t divided by tau. So, this will be V S will be cancelled. So, we will get V s into e to power minus t divided by tau. This is inductor voltage at any time t. Now, let me try to find out the inductor voltage with this formula. We will use inductor voltage at any time t is equal to the inductor voltage in a steady state minus inductor voltage in a steady state minus inductor voltage, initial inductor voltage. Now, this initial inductor voltage is, as I told you, this is inductor voltage right after the closing this the switch. Means this is not at t equal to 0 minus, because the t equal to 0 minus is the instant before t equal to 0, and before t equal to 0 the switch was closed. So, we will use it at t equal to 0 plus. And now, here I will show you the V L naught at t equal to 0 plus and at t equal to 0 minus is different. So, this is V L infinity minus V L naught into e to power minus t divided by tau. Now, if the switch was not closed, if the switch is open circuited, I L was 0, there was no inductor current. If the I L was 0 and I L was constant at 0, so if I L was constant at 0, V L is equal to L before closing this, L d I L over d t is equal to, because I L was constant at before t equal to 0, this quantity is constant, so V L will be 0. So, we will say that V L at t equal to 0 minus is equal to 0. Now, when the switch was closed, now before closing the switch, inductor current was 0. So, even right after the closing the switch, the inductor current will also be 0. So, if inductor current is 0, the resistance current will also be 0, and if resistance current is 0, there will be no voltage drop across resistance. So, the whole source voltage will drop across inductor. So, we will say that the inductor voltage right after the closing the switch, which is t equal to 0 plus, this is equal to V s, this is not equal to 0. I am repeating it again, before closing the switch inductor current was 0. So, right after closing the switch inductor current will be 0. If inductor current is 0, resistance current will be 0. So, there will be no voltage drop across this resistance. If there is no voltage drop across resistance, the whole source voltage will drop across the inductor. So, these two values are different, and we have to use the initial inductor voltage after the transient has occurred, after t equal to 0. So, V L t is equal to, and what is inductor voltage in a steady state? In a steady state, I L will be constant. So, inductor voltage will be 0, or in a steady state, inductor is short circuited. So, V L infinity is equal to 0 minus 0 minus V L naught is equal to V S into e to power minus t divided by tau. So, this we will get V S into e to power minus t divided by tau. This is same as this. Now, let us move in RC circuit. This equation can also be derived using Laplace equation. So, I am leaving it up to you to derive it using Laplace.